How does it feel to be here at the MCM London Comic Con? Are you enjoying yourself?
It's amazing. I didn't think it was going to be so huge. I mean, I was walking through and I went to the pub across the street. And I had to call Angelia, the girl that's handling me today, because I got lost and I didn't know where that guy was. And it's just a huge mob of people. It's pretty amazing.
And talking about amazing, for people who haven't seen Starcross yet, can you just set us up with a quick synopsis? What's all about?
It's basically an alien ship crashes on Earth, and I am one of seven aliens, but our whole race is imprisoned in this sector. And then 10 years later, they choose seven of us to get integrated into the Earth school system. So it's like the trials and tribulations of that. And there's a love story, alien boy meets human girl. There's the Romeo and Juliet. So it's a really cool show. I loved it. And I loved my character. Originally, I didn't think the character was going to be so prominent in the show. And they kind of... they liked the character and they expanded on him, and I loved every second of shooting that show. We have Matt Lanter from 90210 and Mae T. Garden from Friday Night Lights. They're both great. They're the two leads. My love interest, Natalie Hall, she was the best actress I've ever worked with. She's like, went to an acting high school, performing arts high school. I mean, she's really classically trained. And for someone like me that kind of just goes off of instinct, it was really nice to just work with someone like that. And we helped each other out. And it was an amazing process.
I mean, talking about instinct, how did you get a feel for the character?
I mean, he has so many different layers. It was almost like impossible to mess it up because, like, he has all these different emotions and all these things going on that, like, no matter what I did, I think they were just like, yeah, Drake's feeling that, Drake's feeling this, and it was kind of easy. It was fun. As an actor, it was fun to play an alien because there's so many things that you can kind of make up on your own because nobody really knows. Like, we had our whole language, and the joke on set was like, if you get the language wrong, no one's really going to tell you it's wrong because no one knows what the heck it is. And I think the world, you know, I can speak for my show, the world that Meredith and Adele, the creators, created was just so intricate. And I think that's what people dig about sci-fi and fantasy, is that there's this whole fantasy world that's created that you can kind of just pick from, and it's, your imagination just runs wild. It's great.
I mean, are you a fan of that type of stuff yourself? I mean, are there any particular shows or films?
I'm a huge Lord of the Rings fan. I loved the Lord of the Rings trilogies, and I love what they did with the first two Hobbits so far, and that's my thing, yeah. I think they were going to really, like, delve into the Elgida. We were going to go there and see what that was like. I was really looking forward to see what that was going to look like and what the set was going to look like for that. So that would have been fun to see.
I mean, looking back on what you did get to realize on screen, is there a particular episode that you either enjoyed making the most or you're just most proud of?
The last episode was pretty amazing. And we were rushing so hard to get it done because there was all these, like, action scenes and stuff like that. And we all had to, like, come together and get down and just really, really work hard and not mess up, and a lot of long days. And I think the final episode came out amazing. That final scene was pretty epic. I did a show for 5 years, so we were kind of spoiled that way. But yeah, I mean, it's just tough. There's so much television now. There's so many great shows on TV, so it's really competitive. You never know why. Like, with us, we were on Monday night at 8 o'clock, so we were competing against, like, The Voice and Dancing with the Stars, and we aired during the Olympics. So, I mean, we were thrown in with the sharks for sure.
And in terms of when you do get to meet fans at events like this, what do they most often ask you about? What kind of stuff and things you've done in the past? Like, what are they always anxious to chat about?
They're actually interested in what I'm doing next, which is really flattering and nice because they want to kind of follow my career, which means a lot to me, which is cool.
And what else have you got coming up at the moment?
I wrote a film called Danny Boy that I'm starring in and producing, and we should be starting that in the fall. So look out for Danny Boy. It's going to be good.
Can you give us a quick synopsis of that?
It's an Irish crime drama. This kid, Danny, he grows up in this Irish crime family. He's a boxer, and his family, basically his mom and his brother, die on the way to one of his boxing matches, and he never wants to box again, so he gets, swept up into this Irish crime, and there's a love story in there, and then his uncle gets into a huge gambling debt, and he's got to fight in this underground fight ring to get his uncle out of the gambling debt. It's very barbaric. It's very, like, gladiator times, you know, it's just one guy, you know, one-on-one, and it's fair. You know, the best man wins. There's no cheating. It's just a mano-a-mano, and people in it, you really have to fight your hardest, and I think people relate to that.
Have you had any memorable fan encounters, any funny ones, any interesting ones?
Not yet. I always think it's cool when guys come up to me, because it's always mostly like the teenage girls because of my other show, and I always think it's really cool. Like this, I did WonderCon a couple months ago, and this little seven-year-old boy like was with his mom, and he looked up, he's like, "That's Drake," and it was like cool because he was looking at me like I was like I used to look at like a baseball player or a basketball player. Like, so it's always neat when like guys know who I am. So,
I mean, in terms of looking up to people as an actor, who do you admire? Like, who inspires you?
Leo was a big one for me. Basketball Diaries was one of the movies that made me want to be an actor. Mark Wahlberg, we come from the same area, so that's kind of he's kind of a role model for me. Jack Nicholson was always my dad's favorite. I was brought up on him. There's a lot of great ones, yeah. You know, I did a Law & Order just a couple months ago in Mariska Hargitay. Forgive me if I'm butchering her name, but she was amazing. Like, she's been on that show for 15 years. It's basically her show, and she's still so passionate about each scene and each episode. She really wants to get it right, and that was, like, very humbling as an actor and very inspirational as well. I mean, I was never big on sci-fi, but, I mean, I would, you know, doing Starcrossed for a season, I kind of really got into it. That'd be, you know, but the role I wrote for myself was kind of my dream role, so hopefully I'll be doing it in the fall.
Do you have a message for fans before you leave us?
Thank you guys so much for following my career and showing up today. It means a lot, and I hope to have more work for you guys to follow. Thank you.